3D animations can provide companies of almost any industry with huge leverage in improving their operational efficiency in nearly all aspects of their business, and therefore also gain many cost benefits. Greater understanding of the design from concept stage to when it is in the factory, animations can help throughout the design process. You can convey more information and go further than pictures can because of things such as cross-sections, transparency, and explosions that just wouldn't be possible or would take significant time and effort in real life. Due to this understanding, costs can be saved with mistakes and issues fixed earlier in the product life cycle. What you are currently watching is a quick example of an animation to show the features of the GoPro gimbal. These animations were created in SOLIDWORKS and then exported to SOLIDWORKS Visualize for rendering. Animations is built right into SOLIDWORKS interface, so no need to transfer to another program or add-in, and can all be done with all licenses of SOLIDWORKS. The motion manager will be turned on by default when SOLIDWORKS is installed and can be found at the bottom of the screen, just above the status bar. When one of the tabs is activated, the timeline will appear. The drop-down in the top left is what type of motion you want to create. Animation and basic motion will be in all SOLIDWORKS versions. The animation option allows us to control mates and motors, and basic motion allows adding mass and context between parts. Motion analysis is a simulation add-in that allows you to add forces and get physics results out with charts and data. This is only available within SOLIDWORKS Premium. None of the animations I show you in this video use anything other than the animation option. As you can see, you get a full copy of the feature tree with a timeline for each part that represents time-based changes. We can create what we call keys at different times in the timeline. If these keys are different from what their neighbors are, then SOLIDWORKS will put in what we call the change bar between them, which represents during this time something is changing. The color of this change bar depends on what is changing between the keys, as we can animate movement of geometry in different ways, but also hide and show parts, change mates, appearances, cameras, and even lights, all of which are again controlled using keys and change bars. To show how easy it is to create one of the animations shown earlier, I'm going to create the animation of a GoPro being attached to the gimbal. Before I go to the animation in the model tab, we can see I have already created an exploded view. This is an extremely simple exploded view rotating the mount in the camera, but this can be as many steps as you want and might have already been created to show an exploded view in the drawing. You can create it from here and even save it, but we will bring it into the timeline as it will give us full control on what is happening. I will activate the motion study 1 and right click to rename. The initial keys are whatever it looked like in the model tab when this motion study was created. Using the animation wizard tool, I will choose to bring in the exploded view with a slightly delayed start time. This will create the keys for the animation we saw in the model tab. These can be modified or deleted if necessary. Next, I will create the animations straight within the timeline. First, I will pull the camera down onto the mount. I want this to happen after the arms come down, and therefore I will move my time bar to 3 seconds and place a key. This is to ensure the camera does not move from 0 to 3 seconds because the keys are the same. Next, I will move to 5 seconds, ensure auto keys is on, so as soon as I make a change in the viewport, a key is created at the 5 seconds, and then I will drag the camera down. Next, I shall show the holding screw and show it screwing onto the mount. It is currently hidden and I don't want to make it visible until 5 seconds, and therefore I shall again select the part and place key. I'll move to 6 seconds and then show the part to fade it in. Notice a key is again created at 6 seconds because of the auto keys feature. This key is different to the key at 5 seconds, and therefore the change bar is created and the part will interpolate between the two different states. The position of the screw is not free like the camera was and is actually controlled with a mate. Therefore, I shall animate this mate changing instead. It is the same idea, except now you are changing a value rather than just moving the part in the viewport. I have renamed the mate distance of screw to make it easier to find. For this mate, I shall place a key so it doesn't change until 6 seconds, and then at 9 seconds double-click the mate and change the value to move the screw in. This works okay, but this looks like we are simply pushing the screw in rather than screwing it in. Therefore, the last way to display parts moving is motors, and we shall add a rotary motor to show the screw rotating. There are many different ways to control the motor, but I shall use distance in degrees of 720 and then have it only coming on at 7 seconds in the timeline for 2 seconds. Once complete, it will appear at the top of the motion study feature tree and can be edited or suppressed as necessary. The orientation of the model is constant to what it was when we created the motion study. We can change it, but when we play the animation, it will jump back to its original position. I will move back to 0 seconds and turn off the tool preventing any orientation being saved. By right-clicking on the orientation and camera views and disabling the option Disable View Key Creation, I can then activate the camera and it will remember this change. I can then use the same auto keys controls to change what the camera is looking at and create keys to animate it. To output the animation, we can save an MP4 of what it looked like on screen with a set size and frame rate, or a photo view renderer if we have SOLIDWORKS Professional. If we want the most photorealistic animation, we can use Visualize Professional. This is an extra purchase, further to what you get when you purchase SOLIDWORKS Professional, but it allows us to export animations as well as create animations, VRs, interactive image, and generally give the viewer more of an experience with the model. To export it, we can use the Visualize add-in to export advanced. It will take through all animations from SOLIDWORKS, except for in-context and assembly level features, which can be used in SOLIDWORKS to deform parts. If we want to learn more about animations or Visualize, we have training courses that will cover what we have covered in more detail, as well as much, much more. Be sure to check them out.